I'll be 75 years old in August, and that's how long I lived in Clendenin. And that is a long time.
Sharon Hensley is a lifelong resident of Clendenin, West Virginia. She is one of many victims of the West Virginia floods that have devastated the state. But her story is one of collaboration and commitment, an 18-hour rescue effort she will never forget.
We have personally never been flooded. Our house, I went to go see what was going on. And I knew better, but I walked up, started going up that bank. And I turned around, and when I did, it was just like I hit the ground. I could hear my bones pop.
We heard a dispatch for a elderly female with a possible femur fracture. Once we got on scene, we had to walk her across water.
First trip out on an old board, across that creek.
We carried her in the back of a pickup truck across a section of water.
Then back out, loaded me into the ambulance.
We had planned on meeting that second unit halfway on the other side of the water. Problem is, they got trapped.
The ambulance went down and got as far as Heiser's trucking. Couldn't make it no further. Turned around and tried to go the other way. Got blocked there.
We were trapped between Clendenin and that section of water. And every idea we had, it's like, hey, how about this? And they're like, okay. And then they would come back, sorry, we can't do that.
Oh no, it just seemed like nothing was working for the good.
HealthNet, which is our aeromedical service, couldn't fly. AirEvac, which is the next closest aeromedical service, couldn't fly.
And nobody could get in or out or anything, so we just sat there the whole time.
18 hours of primary patient care with a broken femur.
And it hurt. Every breath I took, it hurt.
It was the most mentally draining call I've ever ran.
Medevacs were grounded, and there seemed to be little chance of an air evacuation. Enter the West Virginia National Guard, pilots and crew that are trained to fly in austere environments.
We landed, and we went out, and we went to look for the woman with the broken femur. We couldn't find them, and we were starting to run out of fuel, and we went straight back out as soon as we got fuel. We got to the point where I was like, you know, I'm going to start just texting and messaging, making contact with Mr. Rucker.
He had texted me a couple times, said, where are you at? And I took a picture on Google Maps of where I was so he could triangulate, because where we were is not easy to see us.
Everyone here in aviation, I think we all love our job and we love being able to do it. And it's, you know, if we could do it, we'll do it.
18 hours, and then here comes the Black Hawk.
So we got within 2 miles. Told him to pop his smoke, which was actually a fire that he had made. It wasn't a canister of smoke. We landed in that yard.
You know, it was a huge collaboration. I'm a huge believer in the military anyway, and the fact that we have those units that close, if we need them, they're there, and that's what it's all about. We appreciate it a lot.
When you see like the National Guard commercials, join up, do this, you'll get to see the world, you'll get to serve your country, like, that's it, I'm doing it now. Like, I'm doing what I signed up for. So it's a pretty fulfilling feeling.
I really appreciate what they done and everything to get me up there for one lonely 75-year-old woman anyway.
For the West Virginia National Guard, I'm Army Sergeant Mickey Miller.